Welcome everyone. I'm here with Professor Helen Ball from the UK, and we're here to talk a little bit about her presentation for Gold Perinatal 2014, which is titled Sleep Ecology and Development in Early Infancy. Welcome Helen, we are thrilled to have you presenting with us this year. So just a couple of questions for you. First one is, what do you think is the biggest challenge for parents when it comes to infant sleep?
Okay, that's a good one. I think the first thing is that what parents think it is probably quite different from what I think it is. I hear a lot of parents talk about their baby's sleep, and they think their biggest challenge is to get their baby to go to sleep and to stay asleep, and to be staying asleep all night as soon as they possibly can. I think the biggest challenge that they face, therefore, is to recognize and remember that babies don't sleep like adults. And it takes quite a long time for babies to develop an adult sleeping pattern. So they need to accommodate their own behavior to meet their baby's needs with regards to sleep, rather than trying to encourage, cajole, manipulate, whatever, their babies to fit their own sleep patterns.
Thank you. Yes, it's definitely a big adjustment with the baby and having to manage those expectations of what infant sleep should look like. What do you think is the biggest challenge for healthcare providers when it comes to helping parents with their concerns about infant sleep?
Well, what I would like health providers to take from this presentation is that a lot of our attitudes about infant sleep are based on cultural assumptions or myths that have developed around what babies should be doing. And so when they're talking to parents about infant sleep, there are two things that I'd like to bear in mind. One is that they shouldn't be giving parents advice or guidance or whatever based on kind of popular culture about infant sleep or things that they experienced in their own personal kind of infant care experiences. And the other is that all families will manage the period of infancy and infant sleep differently. And so there isn't a kind of one-size-fits-all approach that works for everybody. So I'd like healthcare providers to be giving parents evidence-based information, and if there is no research, then tell parents that there is no research on which to base any recommendations, and therefore they need to make their own decisions about this kind of thing.
Wonderful, thank you. I agree, it's so important to make sure that parents are being given individualized help and that they're being given evidence-based information. So definitely really looking forward to your presentation. I think a lot of people are really keen to hear this research. It's such a hot topic right now. So thank you so much. And we're really looking forward to hearing your presentation this year. Thank you.